surpass time. He can surpass your reasoning, your understanding. He can do anything. I mean anything. Isn't he worthy of our praise today?
Amen.
Amen. Let's stand and sing number 65, The Wonder of It All. Get your exercises.
Continue in prayer for Dr. Hogan and Joe. He's been moved to high
health and rehab in Bella Vista, and he's battling the infection and also progressed effects of Parkinson's disease. So certainly keep them folks in your prayers. Lift up Kate and Caitlin Brown as Kate draws near to her due date. Pray for Denny Gold, that's my cousin, as he's battling ALS. Lift up William and Judy Mullins, as they're both not feeling well and continuing battling long-term health effects, including William having shingles, which is no fun at all. Certainly keep all those folks in your prayers. Remember those battling cancer, including Abby Coonrod, Mary Coons, Peggy Dillahunty, David Harwood, Brad Hickman, Chris Blidner, Janice Henson, Reagan Henson, Zach Moore, Eric Lammers, Hunter Nichols, Jody Poole, Kane Ruiz, Beth Siler, Mike Thompson, Cecil Todd, David Watson, Tyler B. Wesley, and also remember a local guy here, Timmy Yen, as doctors have found spots on his lungs and are running for their test. Certainly keep all those folks and their families and their doctors in your prayers. Be in prayer for those serving our nation, including Matt Valley, Tim Ringer, Isaac Dan, Devin Doss, Star Hawkins, Sean McKinney, Alex Olson, Ben Skelton, and Kevin Stowe. Keep those folks and their families in your prayer. Keep praying, being in prayer throughout the school year. Pray for the students, parents, teachers, administrators, and all the staff. And remember our college students, including Caitlin Brown and Jonathan Brinkley. Also, some addresses there if you'd like to send them a card and encourage them to look. Do we have any additions to our prayer list? If not, would you take these needs to your Heavenly Father with me? Father, we just give you thanks for the privilege and the opportunity of being in your house this day. Father, we know that you're the great physician. You're the same yesterday, today, and tomorrow. And Father, we lift up each one of these people we've spoken of here to you this day. Each one has their own problems, and Father, we know you have the answer to each and every problem. Father, again, we just ask your healing hand upon them. Father, we give you thanks for the honor, the privilege of lifting up our friends and brothers and neighbors to you. In your Son Jesus' name, we pray these things. Amen.
Take just a second and think about your week, last week. Sometimes it's hard about Sunday to think about last week, right? And like, wait, I've slept since then. But think about last week and what was the most amazing thing that happened to you last week? Just take a moment and think about it. Maybe God provided you an opportunity to make someone smile. Maybe God provided you an opportunity to encourage somebody. Maybe you just got to see a beautiful sunrise or a beautiful sunset. Or maybe something really big happened. Like, I don't know, something really big. Like you've been praying for something for a long time and poof, the prayer came true. Just think about that for a second. What are you thankful for? Anybody want to share? You might just be thankful he woke you up. Amen. Some mornings, that's me. I'm grateful for coffee every day.
But God loves us so much.
That God loves us so much.
Constantly. He is my best friend. He is my God. He is my Savior. He's my eternal husband. He is my guide in everything I do. And he blesses me continually with peace and joy in his presence in my home. Or actually in his home. He allows me to be there and stay there with him. And I'm very, very thankful for him.
Amen. Anybody else have a praise they want to thank this morning God for?
I think our church family and our community. We experienced our church family last and other church families last Sunday night, you know, when we went to grab it. I was telling in Sunday school why my my battery decided to have to die this week. And I never felt that I was stranded because I got in the car, it went click, click. Two ladies, before I even clicked it again, was there saying, can we jump in? You know, there, I had several people that came to my help before RA and they got in. I think of the blessing, I take the shower.
That's right.
Very true.
Yeah. Last Sunday when we went to the Rabbit Church, it was pretty cool because there were all kinds of churches there. It wasn't just us and the Rabbit Church, but there were two or three churches there. And, you know, and we didn't know a lot of those people, and it's just like, wow, that's really cool. That's what it's going to be like when we get to heaven. People you don't even know will be there, but they'll all be praising God together. And you can feel the love, and you can feel the Holy Spirit, and you can just, I can't wait for that day.
And we got to listen to Carol sing.
And Carol blessed us with a song. Yes, it was beautiful. Yes, we had so much fun. Anything else?
Hearing about answered prayers. We heard today in Sunday school class about a couple that were answered, and experienced some through the week about some of the prayers, and answered oftentimes in unexpected ways.
I have an example of that. I accidentally called Annabelle. I was calling Annabelle and I accidentally called a friend from Day Spring. We were catching up. I was telling her that a gentleman from Fellowship Church has offered to disciple Alex. I'm telling her that on the phone. So she sends me this week. Listen to this. We have a friend at church whose brother has been in rehab in Tulsa area for a year. A week ago, Wednesday night, 24th, the day you sent me the above text, they asked for prayer for him now that he's getting out. I shared with them that a man who wants to disciple Alex, we prayed specifically for a man to do that for his brother. I just got a text from our friend saying a man had asked his brother on the 29th if he could disciple him. 5 days after we prayed, what an awesome God we serve. But if you hadn't told me about Alex, I would never have thought to pray that prayer. Thank you so much. I know you will praise God with us.
Amen.
And here I am bumbling around trying to call Annabelle, made a mistake, called somebody else. But it's not a mistake in God. God's plan was being worked out.
Yeah, it's amazing, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's amazing. And I always think it's such a blessing when he helps us to see that too.
Yeah.
Right? And sometimes it's kind of like, yesterday I kept trying to put my debit card in the little machine, and you know, they're all different. They all ask you 100 questions, or they don't ask you questions, I don't know. But it said, leave your card in the machine, and I thought it said, take your card out of the machine, right? So I take it out, and the lady's like, no, you know, and I'm like, I'm sorry. And so yeah, she had to do all her stuff again, I put it back in. Sometimes it's like that, you know, we unconsciously just do stuff, because we do it all the time. But that's like all of the blessings that God gives us. Sometimes we don't see them. We just do it and we put it back in. And we work through life just doing what we do.
Yeah.
And we don't even take the time to see those beautiful, beautiful blessings and see those answered prayers. So this morning we're going to sing number 98, Jesus, I Just Want to Thank You. And as we sing this song, I just hope that you can feel all the blessings that he's given you throughout your whole life. Please stand and we'll sing number 98.
Be so good.
Good morning.
Morning.
Good morning.
Blessing to be here this morning. So at work I do quite a little bit of driving. And I have this satellite radio thing in my car. And every once in a while I just kind of hit the scan button and see what comes up. And anyway, the other day I hit the scan button and I landed on this song a couple of weeks. It really kind of stuck in my mind for a little bit. It was a Charlie Daniels song. I knew down the guy had a Charlie Daniels song, right? Well, anyhow, it's a kind of a neat, you know, it's a nice swing to it. If you listen to Charlie Daniels or you know what song I'm talking about, but anyhow, it's a song about a long-haired country boy, okay? So anyway, there's a phrase in there that really kind of stuck in my brain a little bit. He says, and I think it's in the chorus, but anyhow, he says something to the effect of, I ain't asking, this is a classic lyrics, I ain't asking for nothing if I can't get it on my own. You heard that? John's heard it, I can tell. So, no? So, anyway, he says, I don't want anything if I can't get it on my own. So a little bit later, I'm thinking about that, and I thought, you know, sometimes I kind of act like that. You know, something breaks at home, I'm not going to do about this. I got to fix this. I got to do this on my own. This thing is broken, or this needs fixing, this needs done. How am I going to fix that? How am I going to take care of that? And it happens with other things in life, not just broken things. But sometimes we think, what am I going to be able to do about that? But this song says, I don't want anything if I can't get it on my own. This morning, we come around this communion table. We come to this time to remember Jesus, to be reminded that we can't do this on our own. What that is pride, by the way. That's my pride when I think, I got to fix everything. I got to do this. I got to do that. I need to be reminded. I need to be humble this morning that I cannot approach God on my own. I cannot be righteous on my own. I cannot be holy on my own. It's only through Jesus. That's what this time is for, is to remind us that Jesus has paid the price that we could not pay. And he has redeemed us, and he has done something that I just can't possibly do on my own. All I can do is accept his grace. There are things that we need to do in response to that, but Paul reminds us in Ephesians, and we talked all the way around this in Sunday school class this morning, but in Ephesians in chapter 2, in verse 8, Paul says, For by grace you have been saved through faith, and not of yourselves, it is the gift of God, not of works, lest anyone should boast. There's no boasting this morning, except in Jesus. This morning we come to a time to be reminded of Jesus' body broken by this little piece of bread, to be reminded by this little cup of juice of his blood poured out on the cross, on Calvary, for me, that he is the only way, he is the only access, he is the only path to heaven. And this morning we need to be reminded of that, and I need to be humbled to know that this morning. Would you pray with me? Gracious Father in heaven, we thank you so much for your grace and for your mercy. Indeed, we want to thank you, to say we love you, to say we adore you, to say that we want to serve you. Father, we pray that you'll help us as we partake this morning, as we gather around this table, Father, as we did last week and the week before. Father, let us not do this out of routine. Let us not do this out of habit, but out of worship, out of adoration, out of recognizing Jesus as our Redeemer, as Jesus as our substitute, paying the price that we couldn't begin to pay, doing something we can't possibly do on our own, and to just honor you and praise you this morning. In Jesus' name.
Our meditation hymn this morning is number 183, Beneath the Cross of Jesus.
Thank you.
Take the cross, Christ, and Whatever you're ready, we're gonna.